What happened?
Six of the hostages went out a back exit.
Where are they? The Canadian ambassador's house.
Got Revolutionary Guards going door to door. These people die. They die badly.
White House?
Who wants the six of them out?
What we like for this are bicycles.
Hi, I'm Lou Luminick, chief film critic of the New York Post, here with a review of Argo.
A blue-chip Oscar contender that's also a rousing popcorn movie, Ben Affleck's Argo offers plenty of nail-biting thrills, as well as funnier scenes than you'd ever imagine possible in the grim context of the 1980 Iran hostage crisis. The long-classified true story of how the six were able to finally sneak out of Iran by posing as the Canadian crew of a phony science fiction film led by a steel-nerved CIA agent turned improbable modern-day Moses is stranger than any fiction that Hollywood could possibly invent. This preposterous and dangerous-sounding scheme is the brainchild of a CIA extraction expert named Tony Mendez, played by a bearded Affleck in his finest screen performance to date.
Or you could just send in training wheels and meet them at the border with Gatorade.
Tony.
It's 300 miles to the Turkish border. They'd need a support team following them with a tire pump.
We were just asked to sharpshoot this. State is handling the op.
I'm sorry, who is this?
Tony's an Exville special. You got a lot of the Shaw's people out after the fall.
It's winter. You can't afford to wait around till spring, so it's nice enough to take a bike ride. The only way out of that city is the airport. You build new cover identities for him, you send in a Moses, he takes him out on a commercial flight.
Chris Terrio's superb script takes what I'd consider acceptable liberties with the facts, especially in the final section. This allows Affleck to offer some white-knuckle suspense for a grand show and a slam-bang ending to Argo that's guaranteed to have audiences cheering. Well, maybe not in Iran.
So I'm giving Argo 4 stars out of 4. I'm Lou Luminick, and you can find my reviews at nypost.com.
We're responsible for these people.